Going to the land of the rising sun.
Your friends going
This is a clarion call from Edith of Fossils on Wine in Aba Abia Province. In the leadership of Mazinam the Kanu, we are in this platform for the restoration of Biafra because we are proud of the land of rising sun. Biafras are blessed with natural resources, we are blessed with human resources, we are blessed with great technology and so on and so forth. We never call for war, we never call for hatred. We never call for discrimination, but we call for peace, unity, love, freedom, which is our main goal. Biafra is an ancient nation which was earlier colonized by the British in the earlier 18th century. And Biafra nation has been foretold in the prophecies by Nostradamus 100 years back that a powerful prince will arise in the world as the trigger of the gun, that he will feed the envy of other princes, and the other prince will try to subdue his arise, but all will be a failure to them. Biafra is an ancient nation that lies along the Atlantic Ocean of Africa with great potential of greatness. Biafra is a nation that will restore peace, liberation, future hope towards our generation. Our predecessors have fought their own, and we present Biafras are not going to relent or surrender to this struggle. We are determined to restore our holy land, which is Biafra, with one voice, one accord, one command, and one agenda, which is Biafra. We all thank Almighty Chukwu Okike Adeyemo for his grace, protection, love, care, because we are all alive in the land of the living. God has organized a scheme peace province in Biafra land. Biafra, you are great indeed, the kingdom of God here on earth. We also thank our leader Mazinam Kanu, the great prince and an icon, the liberator of this global struggle of our time, and Deputy Master 24, and all the principal of state, coordinators, high group family members all around the world. Lovers of radio, this song is from Casey Joe and Derry from Fossils on Wine in Aba, Abia Province. Thank you all, and the Chukwu Abia, my blessing all in your West.
Yes, once again, fellow Biafrans lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, conscious people, wherever you are all over the world, I will say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra, and we are streaming live through Radio Biafra London, being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mazi Uchi Okafor-Mefo. He is from Abatiti. Abatiti is in Anambra State, and Anambra State is Biafra land. Is the man who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. He's standing in a deputizing capacity on behalf of our Supreme Leader, Mazen Nandioku Kanu, the Prince of Afaribeku, heir to the throne of Ibeku Kingdom, the one and the only man that stood up to speak for the collective interest of the Biafran people for almost 6 decades. And by the grace of Chukwu Okike Adeyemo, is from Afaribeku. Afaribeku is in Umuahia. Umuahia is in Abia State, and Abia State is Biafra land. By the special grace of Chukwu Okike Adeyemo, I remain George Unibe. I am from Abo. Abo is in Delta State, and Delta State is Biafra land. Of course, as always, we must acknowledge the creator, Chukwu Okike Adeyemo, who has given us yet another privilege. Beginning of a new dawn, I should say. And we will make proper use of all of them from this moment till Biafra is restored. And so I will humble myself and acknowledge him, for in the end, he is a hope and stay. And so in my own way, I see. Anye na jage mao, mihi na imara mai, ihonanya ene nage, ubiomage, ujuru anyanya dadio, ingwe gimbangwe o, odi unye dikage, ibu wafa no mega, anye nine na sena ne de mao. Of course, without wasting much of our time, we shall go to our topic this evening. It's a kind of reminder. It is a kind of calling upon us to open our eyes, to look before we leap, to observe what is going on. Because in the end, there is no two ways about it. We are here in the first place because we want to stop Nigeria. There is no two ways of expressing our desire. We are not here for a torture.
We are not here for constitutional amendment. We are not here to ask for reparation. We are not here to ask for compensation. We are not here for reconstruction, rehabilitation, and what is the other? We're not here for any of them. Even though they make them available. At this point in time, 1 million seaports in Biafra land will not change anything. 100 international airports in Biafra land will not change anything. Every farm road in Biafra land tied will not change anything. Availability of drinking water will not change anything. Not to talk of Igbo presidency or Oguni clean up. No, it is too late for Nigeria and the handlers of Nigeria. And as such, they will not let us go, but they shall in the end. And so we come every day, keep reminding you about what is to come. Because if certain group of individuals will congregate around themselves and say they will kill us, and in order to kill us, they will walk 1,000 miles to come and kill us, and then we are not ready to walk 20,000 miles to defend ourselves, and that means we are not the children of our father. Our leaders say, if as much as we don't want to fight them, but they will fight us eventually. And so what do? We now begin to do Arabanko, begin to speak in tongue. Do you know the crusaders didn't speak in tongue? But that is a case for another day. And so sometime, I would rather refer it as a moment of reflection. So you begin to reconsider your way. Some people are spending their energy. Let's deal with Inan the Kano. Let us go to Masu Mefo. Let us deal with all of them. This IPOB, we are saving your people. We are saving your children. That is what we are here to do. You leave Fulani herdsmen alone. You leave Miati Allah alone. You leave Boko Haram alone. You leave British government alone. And you think we are the one that you can toy with. And so if you are any idiot contesting with IPOB, you are in for the greatest shock of your life. It's a promise. It's a promise. You have our bet. You have our chere. When you are supposed to be giving it to all those idiots on the checking point, you are bringing it to your brother. People like you are the reason why some of us were meant to believe that our ancestors are evil. You are the evil one who will expose you alongside Nigeria. Some of you who are Biafrans now, because you are answering our surname, or you have been placed in the Nigerian army, custom, immigration, Boko Haram, or as the case may be, to kill your own people, you think you are Vandana. We watch all of you. We are monitoring all of you. Those of you who are there, very eager, they put you and Fulani on the checking point. You will sit down on the chair, and you are the one that will come and be harassing us and intimidating us because you think you know us. A man's enemy will be members of his own household. We are not ignorant of these issues. But I think let today, the 1st of January, the year of Chukwuka Abiama, 2020, let it be a moment of reflection for you. Because it's as simple as that. And having said that, our topic this evening is simple. Initiative to catch us off guard. The initiative to capture us off guard. That is our topic. The British Nigerian from inception has initiated method and protocol on how to catch us off guard. The British Nigeria, when I mean the British Nigeria, the British government, the Hausa, Fulani, Yoruba, the saboteur from Biafra land, as well as other oil thieves across the globe. Any country that owns oil company in Nigeria, they are part of the thieves who are making us suffer what we are going through. It doesn't matter whether it's Shell, it's Chevron, it's Eni, it's Saipem, it's Total, it's Mobil. All the oil company in Nigeria, in Biafra land, are part of the people who are doing this evil to us. All of them has ganged up together. They have initiated plan to catch us off guard. And I must tell you to this very moment, it's actually working out for them without our own notice. It is sad that change is a constant thing in life. Everything change. Everything changed, I must tell you, including God. You know, we believe that he changeth not. God does change. The Bible said that in the days of ignorance, God overlooked. But having expressed everything to humanity, expressly, having made them to see the truth, he don't forgive any longer. Did he not change? Everything changed, including God. But it depends on the area of changing. Those are some of the things we want to look at tonight. And so that when you are changing and doing what you are doing, remember that late Buhari promised you change. So when you are changing, you must be very careful what you change to. Now, for you to understand what I mean, by the initiative to catch us off guard, let me tell you how it works. In those days, when we go to the forest to catch rabbits, to hunt for rabbits, there is a method to catch rabbits. You must observe the protocol. Now, let me teach you. Those of you who have not been to the village, you don't know how to dig rabbit. Let me teach you in my place. When you see the entrance, the hole of a rabbit, you now clear the bush within the entrance and you block it. You first of all monitor the leg, make sure the rabbit has gone inside that hole. The moment you are sure, because you will see the footprint of the rabbit, you will know either the rabbit has gone out or the rabbit is still inside. And then you block the mouth. The moment you block the mouth, you now go around and look for the exit point of that rabbit hole. So the moment you see the exit point of that rabbit hole, you block it also. And then we take dry leaf and put it inside a container. Sometimes we put hot pepper and we light it up. We put hole on the bottom of the container, and as we begin to burn that dry leaf inside the container, it begins to release smoke from the other end, which eventually goes into the rabbit hole. But this is why I'm bringing this up. The moment the hole of that rabbit is filled up with smoke, and rabbit cannot survive in the smoke. So what does the rabbit do? The rabbits that are wise, some of them will be determined. Instead of you to catch them, they will rather die and rot inside that pit, inside that hole. You know what they do? They will now quickly construct another chamber. They always gather palm kernel nut in that their hole. They will now quickly construct another chamber and block them. So they, depending on how determined you are, will determine whether they survive or not. But the point is that in most of the rabbit trap or hole we're going to hunt for rabbits, it's not all of them you will get the rabbit. The rabbits that are stupid, once you put small pepper, they want to run out from the exit point, never knowing that you are waiting for them there. You just kill them. But the rabbits that know that there are human beings hunting for them, they keep palm kernel to block the to create another chamber for their safety in the case of eventuality. In other words, rabbits understand that there are men who are hunting for them to eat them. And so any Biafran at this moment who don't know that they consider us as rabbits, they brought pepper, they brought smoke, they have blocked our exit point. Those are the checking points you see everywhere. We are inside the hole. And their mind of mind is that they will tear gas us until we all run out of this country. But let me tell you the truth. We are here to tell you that that rabbit, instead of them to chase us out of this land, everybody will die. And so we are creating a chamber. We have gathered a palm kernel. And if they are so determined to kill us, we will make sure they will labor in vain, because they won't benefit from our dead body in the end. Destruction of Biafran will upset the balance. And without the issue of Biafran receiving justice, the world is guilty and they are on trial already. They will not survive it. It is as simple as that. And so if ordinary rabbits know how to construct a chamber, last line of defense, what are you doing as a Biafran? Okay, you have an exit point. Fulani will save you, Abi. Or your children are safe in diaspora, Abi. Is that your own chamber? You are targeting that exit point. Don't you know we are there? anywhere you hide your children in the world, we are there waiting for them. You think we are joking? Any weapon you are buying, we are waiting for you. But for those who are still hoping on that exit point as a rabbit, we are there already. Because at the end of the day, all men will be liars. Only God will be true. Only the creator, Chukwu Okike Abiama, will be the truth. I want you to begin to understand. Let us refresh our mind. Have you not noticed that the desire to celebrate after we are dead? Have you not noticed that they have desire to celebrate our death? They deliberately lead us to our death. Have you not noticed Nigeria deliberately lead us to our death? They want to kill us. What's when it comes to the issue of Biafra? Biafra is involved. You see them. If their own is kill them, kill them, kill them. Have you not noticed it? This may not be physical killing. They kill your career. They kill your destiny. They kill everything about you. Have you not noticed it? No. Have you not noticed it? They are poisoning food and selling for us. Somebody will say, no, it's a propaganda. If Fulani herdsmen can rape your mother to death, are you telling me that Fulani herdsmen is selling a good cow to you? Fellow Nigerian, no. It's not as if it's just one in a million case. It's rampant on daily basis. Have you not noticed that in our land, if police want to extort ordinary 50 naira from you and you don't have, they can shoot you and kill you? Have you not noticed it? But how long are they going to be doing this and we'll be looking at them? That is the issue. And they say, oh, it doesn't concern us, it doesn't concern us. Barrister Joffo's house was burned down. I understand that it's not only his house that was burned down. Everybody around there, they burnt their house down. Makaniwe webuwe nyaimi huakwa. Webuwe nyaimi huakwa. You are a Biafran and you think it does not concern you. Don't forget that when you beat the eye, the nose also cry. It will meet all of you because there is nowhere. Nowhere. It is as simple as that. Have you not noticed that life is becoming meaningless to the people of Nigeria on a daily basis? Have you not noticed it? Those of you in Port Harcourt, those of you in Biafra, do you notice that there is no carnival, Christmas carnival or New Year carnival? Do you notice that this celebration of Christmas, it doesn't look like Christmas to many people. People have been working hard throughout. Don't you see that life is becoming meaningless? We have to tell ourselves the truth. I'm talking to Nigerian people now. Is your life not becoming meaningless? Every country of the world, they make projects, they make budgets, they plan for the comfort of their people, their citizens. What are your Nigerian leaders doing? British government is using them, as my leader will call them, Hass Nigger. British government are using the Hass Nigger. The Hass Nigger are the Saboteur. The Hass Nigger are the Yoruba. The Hass Nigger are the Hausa. The Hass Nigger are the Fulani. The Hass Nigger is any idiot here in full find itself inside this contraction called Nigeria, and they are fighting against Biafra restoration. The Hass Nigger is any African country that will join them to undermine the sovereign state of Biafra. The Hass Nigger is any international community, as the case may be, that are fighting against the restoration of Biafra because they lack the moral standard or standing to talk about justice, equity, transparency, fairness, not to talk of the rule of law. They don't have what it takes. So you that is a Nigerian supposedly, are you not noticing that life is meaningless in Nigeria? This is New Year. Things are changing. Have you not noticed what they are doing to you on a daily basis? But this is not what the people want. What you are seeing today is not what you want. But the system is reconditioning everybody. And as such, we all play the game of indulgence. And thereby, we compromise. Our life is being changed before our very eyes. This is not what we bargain for. This is not what we want. We don't wish this. We know. But instead of us to rise up and react, knowing fully well that it's our right to civil disobedience, rather we move back into our shell, playing the game of indulgence and thinking that will solve the problem. Somewhere along the line, God is going to do it. I was glad when I heard one man of God I respect this morning. He was preaching on the radio. He said, "Don't let anybody deceive you. God will not do anything for you except to do that thing for yourself." Of course, they are listening to Radio Biafra. God will not do what man should do for themselves. I'm happy for him because this is not the time where they tell you, drop 50,000, God will give you 1 million naira. Is God a gambler? But they're now making you at least the good ones for you to understand that whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he reap. It is our right to civil disobedience. And as far as these people are determined to deliberately make our life misery, and they are very happy in the situation they are placing you, brother, sister, it is your right to civil disobedience. When they say move, you say no, I will not move. When they say stop, you move. That is exactly what you are doing to them. It's our right. Of course, like our leaders say, they have replaced a secular law system to Sharia law. And so you are under decree, but you will not say it. You know it's wrong, but you will not say it. You prefer to play game of indulgence. That is what we are doing. This is a new year. Let's look at it, for instance. Biafra's and Nigerian military cannot actually find their feet on the ground, because they feel the sense of insecurity themselves as a result of being targeted or maybe victimized. Don't suppose deadly countryman. As you are listening to me, this is the beginning of the year. Use your tongue and count your teeth. You are a Biafran. Whether as a nigger or a genuine Biafran in the Nigerian army, you are constantly gripped by fear of insecurity, fear of uncertainty, because you know you are a target, because you know you can be victimized. But you are a Nigerian army, but you are a Biafran. Don't you feel it? Don't you feel what they do? You know you are a target. I'm talking to our people in the police, in the army. You are carrying AK-47. Your power is to kill us. I'm not talking to Fulani, Yoruba, or Hausa, because their time will come on them. But you are the one I'm talking to. They will take a cross-section of you. They will retire you without benefit. They will take the rest cross-section of you. They will tell you to go and fight Boko Haram with Dengon and Machete. Having equipped Boko Haram with AK-47, you know you will not come. You will not come back. You become a deserted. You run away. And they are hunting for all of you. When they hold you, they say you are a thief. They will blackmail you that you are the one that is using army uniform to rob people. But it's their Boko Haram. Am I lying to you? Don't you know what they are doing to you? But you can't speak up. They lock you up in the guard room, court martial you. But you know, create your chamber. Like the rabbit, begin to create your chamber. Begin to gather your own apakon to create your chamber. They have completed arrangement to get us off guard. And so 90% of Biafran people, if not 99.9% of Biafrans in any security apparatus in the zoo called Nigeria, you have been crippled. You have been crippled. Think about it. They pick the main hard nigger among you just to be informing them. They sabotage you. Check all your guy in Nigerian military, you that is a Biafran. Look at your boss. You will see you are more qualified than them. physically, spiritually, academically, biologically, or otherwise, you are more qualified than them. You not notice they want to catch you off guard? They will send you to Mount Sanctuary with tear gas. The Fulani following you is carrying AK-49. How do you feel about that? And so when they give you order to kill your brother, you refuse, they kill you. And so your life is characterized with sense of insecurity, knowing fully well that you are a target and can be victimized at any moment in time. Biafrans in politics, they are so confused that they don't even understand what politics is all about. So they just merely trying to survive. They know things are wrong, but maybe one way or the other, things is going to be all right in a country supposedly Nigeria. All the Biafran politicians, they are confused. They don't know what to say. They don't know what to do. There is no governor that can come out and talk like governor. No senator, not from Biafra land. Only few of them. They are confused. One Fulani herdsman will come and threaten, supposedly my governor. And my governor will shut up. There are a lot of people who try to show boldness. Where is he, Bekachuku? Since he wanted to blow up that the man in Aso Rock is Jubri, they burnt his house down. And since then, the last time we saw him, he was afar already somewhere in Dubai. What a pathetic life. The same way all these governors of Northern Nigeria, Yoruba, rake. Can any Biafran governor talk like that? Politician, can you people talk like that? They bamboozle you. Your decision is always influenced by the fear of these Northerners, as they call themselves, Fulani. Because you know somewhere along the line that the British government is going to empower them to undermine your position as supposedly our governor. But you are too afraid to fight them. So rather you comply with them to kill us. But who will save you in the end? Will they save you? A lot of people are criminal in Nigeria. But only the half nigger from Biafra land, or Jesus Okalu, is in prison. Only those who fight against Jubri. All of them are the ones the government bulldog will come after. That is EFCC, ICPC, or DSS, as the case may be. Of course, where you hear ESCC, ICPC, DSS, all of them are extraction from Nigerian Boko Haram military or police. Come to think about it. Is that what politics is all about? We come to look at the monarchs too, that was so powerful that everything within our communities were built around them. They represent justice. Our monarch system used to represent peace, security, and prosperity for the people. But today, they barely have a voice. Because the system in Nigeria have subjected all of them to an alien, a system of government that represents death to them as a people. People like Ofaromi Obaisi, people like Nana of Ishekiri, people like Jaja of Opobu, people like Eze Nri of Omambara, people like Eze Wawawa of Nza, they confronted the British. They stood for their rights and all of them died fighting for their rights. They were children of their father. They understand that they are monarchs, they are kings. They are Igwe. They cannot be politically motivated. They died standing for the right of the people. And today you now know why their name will remain in the lips of endless generation. And if they could fight the British, so powerful terrorists like Britain, is it Fulani that can come close to their territory?
Is it Fulani that can come to their territory? Is it Yoruba? But today it's amazing. When a governor representing the Northerners in Biafra land comes to power, they now remove the Igwe and put their own Igwe. Why are the Northern governors not removing Lamido Sanusi among others? They remove it, they will cause opera. Because the people understand the role of the monarch, as well as the monarch understand their duty to the people. But today, give any Igwe money, they will bring Boko Haram to kill you. Majority of them. But are you not ashamed of yourself? If that your throne was ever a genuine throne, you and your know who has failed the people, or you have failed the people. Because only political Olowu will compromise with any of you. But rather, they bamboozle you and reduce you to nothing, that all of you answer to Lamido Sanusi Lamido. Just have a moment of reflection. We are only of Ife coming to talk to you as even Dede. You get to a level you are referred to as Dede. Can only of Ife talk to ordinary Dede? There is what we call Dede. I don't know if this is the same thing it means to other people. When you say somebody is a Dede in my place, it means that in a particular family, the most elderly man we call Dede. If you see the Dede in my own family, he's still alive. Close to 97 years now. But he looked like 32 years old. Very strong. In fact, I fear that man. He's still alive. These were men. Can any of you come and talk to ordinary Dede, not to talk of the king of my place? That was then. But what about today? What about today? One Fulani herdsman will come and ravage the whole community. It is the Igwe, most of the Igwe will be the one to call Boko Haram, Nigeria Army or police, to come and pack the whole youth in the community. I was discussing with my brother today. He said, in Abo now, every woman, every man have to go to the farm with their wife, or else Fulani herdsmen will rape their wife. And now they had a meeting, and what they are discussing now, the men now are now saying, instead of me to escort my wife, go farm, the Fulani can still come out, kill me, rape my wife. No need. Make only my wife they go. That means more Hausa Fulani children inside our land. More idiots will be born for us. Because when your women know you are not ready to protect them, and somewhere along the line they have to survive, they will use their hand to be choosing Hausa Fulani that will be raping them freely, so they will not kill them. And we are going to have more Hausa Fulani inside Biafra land. And when we tell you to go to Abenokpa, idiot will be yapping. But that is not where I'm looking at. You Igwe, that you are killing your people to defend Fulani. Is that how it's supposed to be? But of course, the essence of everything we are seeing is that these people have initiated, they have initiative to catch us off guard. They have plan, protocol put in place already. They want to catch us off guard. A brother that called from Bayelsa said, talk about what Fulani, what all these foreigners are doing to our women in our own land. And there is need for Radio Biafra everywhere in our village. When I'm telling some people, they don't understand. Our women in the village are not enlightened as they should, or compared to those in the town. Those in the city know what's up, but those in the village don't know. And so when they miss their period as a result of rape, they cannot say. They are going to give it to one idiot. And that idiot is going to train Hausa children inside their own father compound. And he's going to bear your father's name. And he will become our doom and the undoing of our people. But all these things are the fault of our Igwe. Tell me the Igwe or any monarch, traditional ruler, that is encouraging their youth in Biafra land here. And will tell you the community that will survive when this will certainly fall down. I hope you are very proud of yourself. I hope you are reflecting to see that what we are telling you is the truth. We go back to the religion. The religion still used to be the symbol of righteousness, morality, an institution I must tell you, they were supposed to be people who brought about sanity in the community. I must tell you, men of God, uncompromised. They cannot be intimidated. But today, they all answer to Lamido, Sanusi Lamido. He's the head of religious leader in Nigeria. They are all be compromised because almost all the whole churches in Biafra land is INEC office. They help INEC to rig majority of the church. We will not stop talking about evil church. We are not fighting against Christianity. We are fighting all of you evil, doing evil in the name of Christian. And so when you are a pastor, you are the one that asked them to vote for Buhari. You help Buhari, lead Buhari into office. Now that Jubri is in power, have you not lost your relevance? Are you too still proud of yourself? When you say you are a man of God and God call you, are you not ashamed of yourself? But having said all these things, as the year is beginning, let us ask ourselves this simple question. If truly our life is changing, is it actually changing in our own terms? If for any reason our life must change, is it changing the way we want to change it to, or we are compelled to change into something that we are not? Ask yourself, whatever you have changed to today, are you sure this is who you want to be? As a policeman from Enugu, working with Nigerian Boko Haram police, and you are seeing your brother extorting money from them, are you sure that is what you want for yourself? As a governor that come out and you say, we that are saying the truth, fighting to save the next generation of our people, those who supposedly vote you into power, you call us terrorists. Are you sure you can justify that declaration? As one Nigeria Yoruba Hausa Fulani, the fear of losing your oil wealth makes you to think that killing us will solve your problem. Are you truly think you are doing the right thing? Is that change you are affecting on us, negatively or positively? Have you considered how it's going to boomerang to you? And the last question is this changing for positive or negative? The influence of your change you are bringing to us, is it a positive change or a negative change? Dear friends, the year is just beginning. When you are changing, be very careful what you change into, because you never know. You never know. Our people must understand that these people have properly and completely initiated plan to catch us off guard. And when everybody thinks that nothing is happening, we're going to move on. It's just like that. Life continue. But you never know that life don't continue. You never know that they are waiting for you when you least expect. And so all we are asking you to do now is rise up, defend Biafra land, stop one Nigeria, but you will never have the privilege to do that again. I'll be back in a minute.
Oh, Nana, land of the right and sun, John Lovine, my originality. Land of the right and sun, Biafra, land of the right and sun. Of the Most High, called by the name of God, the Creator, wise men from the East, South, and the Middle, great Biafran people. But they're killing to idol worship and we lost the face of our God. And as we were alone in night, God was shepherd. The British entered in, trading on the Niger, exploiting your people, trading my battle. You give me palm oil and take soup, so them yesterday I brought in civilization, brought in your religion, and told us about America, and we embraced them. I never knew them got a theory of what, yeah. With religious fitted the some of some brethren, with denomination tear us apart. Building churches, schools and hospitals, we love a new way out of this point to be your slave forever. Oh, Lord, so we fought so hard against them systems, fighting against them schisms. We fought so hard against them systems, fighting against them schisms. But our lives have gone poor. At the very spot we left out when we are gone. Now is the time to be restored. Great Biafra be restored. I want freedom for my people. Freedom for Biafra. I know
Biafra, land of the rising.
Land of the rising sun.
Biafra, my home, my father.
The descendants of Abraham.
Biafra,
from Father Isaac.
Why don't you tell them they want an independent Biafra? Oh, they're fighting for their freedom. So we owe everything to the people that they have asked us to come. Not by our own minds, nor power, nor will, but by the grace of the Lord.
Back in 1914, amalgamation, colonial masters, criminal masters. I'm a celebrity soldier named Frederick Lugar. Brought together all them captives, including your people, them Europeans and them Irish, and so many other people called us Nigeria.
Yes, at this moment, our lines are open. You are Biafran, anywhere you are in the world, it doesn't matter. The only saving ship is IPOB. We'll be asking you to do the right thing. This is a moment of reflection. Everything you have done as a Biafran against the Biafran people, think about it. It's just a plan initiated to catch you off guard. This is the time to come back home. This is the time to come back home. Because somewhere along the line, men gonna do what they gonna do. Send us your name, your phone number, and your location to our WhatsApp line. The nearest coordinator will contact you. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. 070-815-45642. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. 081-221-52971 is our direct line. The special number for the female is 081-288-58614. Special number for the female, I repeat again, is 081-288-58614. We must continue. Call on the line, your name, and where are you calling from?
Call on the line.
Yes, good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
My name is Achibue Ojukwu. I am coming from Abadia State, Mazenube.
Go ahead, please.
Okay. I am here to announce to the whole world and home and to the Biafrans all over the world to tell them that they should remain resolute and march on. If you are stepping on the lion's tail, we are seeing what they are doing. And we are standing firm and we are watching them from behind and waiting for our supreme leader to give us command for us to march them down. We remain resolute and remain fearless before our enemies. And we refuse to bow for them. Whatever thing our so-called politicians are doing on our behalf, we are here telling the world we are not on their side. We are only standing on the behalf of our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Okwukanu, and its deputy, Mazi Uchemoko. Let no one who is under the voice, under my voice this evening, have it at the back of his mind that we are with our so-called and stupid politicians that are against my supreme leader. And let them all have it at the back of their mind that we are against them and please to don't come from their evil doings. Imagine be like today what happened today. So-called policemen, these full animals on black uniform, attacked my brothers. They arrested them, tagged them, IPOB members, took them to Tumorin Barracks and Abba, maltreated them like animals, treated them, handled them like armed robbers while they committed no crime. At the end of the day, our politicians, Bazoo is in charge of other states, will come out to say nothing to us. We suffer pains each day that passes by, our politicians are keeping mute. Well, I'm saying this for the whole world to hear our cry and to hear it that we are shouting it for them to hear. It's not a kind of we are afraid of the zoo. No, they are so-called Boko Haram warriors, not the leader. So let them have it at the back of their mind that when once our supreme leader gives out command, that we will stand and fight them to the core. A stupid man called Inspector John in Abadia State, where he's training out challenge to IPOB members, saying that they have sent him down to Abadia to trap all the IPOB members. He's trying as much as possible to tell our brothers captive, even while they are going for meetings, to mix up with them and betray them inside of the cell. Today, if you go to Cameroon Barracks in Aba Abbey State, you will see many of my brothers being handled inside of there like they've committed one or two crimes while they've committed none, imagine it. It's out of pain, out of what I'm seeing that is going on here in Aba, made me call today. This is my first time of calling. I'm from Ebonyi State, Ishiago precisely. So I am saying this for the whole world to hear our cry, and my supreme leader should be hearing it, that I'm saying it today like today. We are just looking for his command so that we match the zoo down. I watched on Facebook that these hours are full and east, they are marching down to the east. In which I overheard you now when you were saying something of that kind. Imagine you, we are not afraid of what they can do, but we are only afraid of the command of our leader. We are only afraid waiting for when he gives us the command for us to march them down. So I just want to use this medium shirt to say thank you to you, Mazi Nube. Keep keeping on, sir. And to my supreme leader.
Thank you very much.
Mazi Nube and the assistant. Thank you.
We must continue. Caller on the WhatsApp. Your name and where are you calling from?
Good evening to everyone. I am Fidelis Ejiro Obodago, calling from Lagos. I give thanks to every Biafran all over the world. I just want to thank you, say good evening, wherever you are. There is something I just want to say. Mazi Onyibi, God will bless you. When you were giving the illustration of the rabbit and the hoe, how to catch rabbits, in those days. At least I was one of them who also who used the same style, just exactly what the illustration you used when I was in the village as well. So I now find out that reminds me, I begin to think about what is even happening in Lagos here and in Yoruba land and what Yoruba people are doing to Biafrans in Lagos. Number one, last 3 weeks, my vehicle was seized just only because that is my boss, was seized just because I'm not a Yoruba man. And when I was telling them, why are you seizing my motor? The VIO people were saying, because you are not a Yoruba, you are not a Yoruba man. That will not permit me to explain it. The first thing when they saw me, they asked me, they said I should come down, that they are not going to arrest me. They speak Yoruba for me. I reply with English. They asked me to come down. Say my motor gets dent. I said, okay, yes, I understand. The officer now asked me, why are you replying us with English? Are you not Yoruba? I said, no. Immediately he shouted. He said, Omo Igbo ni. He was now reporting to the senior officer. And the senior officer now said, Omo Igbo, they should enter inside the bus and take it to the office. And that is how they took the bus to office. I begged heaven and earth the refuse. The Elijah that I even helped to pick, to drop him in because he's going the same way to my direction, very close to my shop. She now came down and was telling the officer with Yoruba language, telling him, didn't you said you are not going to arrest us because I'm inside the bus? Why are you now arresting the bus now? He said, can't you see with Yoruba? I replied, I went to the senior officer and I explained to him, okay, you said we are Omo Igbo. Okay, I am an Isoko man. I'm from Delta State, from Isoko South local government area, Delta State. Do you know what the senior officer told me? He told me, Papa Blaine, all of you are the same. And that is how I got angry. When I get to the office where they were begging the people, that Elijah was begging other officers. When they now say, Omo Igbo, they say, I was now asking, why is it, did the Igbo kill anybody? Or did the Isoko people kill any of your children? Do you know the reply they gave to me? They said, when we ask you people not to come and vote, when people ask you people not to come and vote, 2019 February, you people still come outside to come and vote. Say if Lagos no feel rich, you make correct, then you go into village. So that is why I said, so it has come to this level. Just as our brothers in Radio Show Market travel back home for Christmas and New Year, they bring their customer and everything. Warehouse that have been closed, locked, and the shops that have been closed, our people are traveling. The custom people came and break it and enter inside the warehouse and the shops and begin to carry their goods. They came with trucks, with soldiers and everything. Imagine that kind of nonsense. So look at it now that they rejected us. They are also trying to kill every one of us, to render us homeless. So we have to find a way to defend ourselves. That is why I was now telling my people from the coastal region, those of you that are still saying up to date that we'll be this, we'll be that. Some of them, especially my Shekiri brothers, will be telling you that we are from Yoruba. Look at what the Yoruba man is telling you, that you and Igbo man is the same. No wonder the director said last time that imagine your enemy to come and begin to tell you your history. That is one of the worst things that